Welcome to Cool Seminary Tutorials. Hi, I'm Professor Wendy. In this video, we'll look at a timeline of the founding of five women's missionary organizations in American Methodist denominations that eventually united to form the International United Methodist Church. These five women's organizations were founded in the 19th century in a period called the Age of Missions because of the large number of missionaries sent out by Protestant Christians during this time frame. The first of these organizations was begun in March of 1869 when a group of women in Boston, Massachusetts determined that a missionary society was needed to help support the missionary efforts of the burgeoning Methodist Episcopal Church. They had heard the pleas of help from several of the wives of the missionaries serving in mission fields, where in many cases only women were allowed to visit, teach, and assist other women. The wives of these missionaries and the group of women in Boston had come to believe that there was particular work needed in the mission field among women that could only be accomplished by women, and it was their call and duty to do what they could to provide it. These women in Boston quickly adopted a constitution and elected national officers for the Women's Foreign Missionary Society of the Methodist Episcopal Church. The first officers, well-regarded leaders in their own right, were the wives of several of the bishops of the denomination. For example, the first president of the Women's Foreign Missionary Society was Mrs. Osmond C. Baker, who was married to, you guessed it, Bishop Baker. The Missionary Society soon began to publish a monthly magazine to provide, quote, showers of instruction and missionary intelligence for auxiliary societies to be formed, quote, in every city, village, and town across the nation. In May, the Society voted to send out its first missionaries, Miss Isabella Thoburn and Dr. Clara Swain, to India. Also in May of 1869, nearly simultaneously with the Methodist Episcopal women in Boston, the Ohio-German Conference of the United Brethren in Christ founded its Schwestermissionverein, or in English, the Sisters Missionary Society. This German-speaking women's missionary organization soon achieved its goal of supporting a missionary of its own, the Reverend F. Lorenz in Parkersburg, West Virginia. 3 years later, in 1872, Miss Lizzie Hoffman initiated a meeting in Dayton, Ohio, for the purpose of organizing a women's missionary society in the Miami, Ohio Conference of the Church of the United Brethren in Christ. In 1876, this organization built two schools in Sierra Leone, West Africa, and shared with its general board the cost of sending Miss Emily Beacon to Sierra Leone to supervise these schools. With the approval of General Conference in 1877, the Women's Missionary Association of the Church of the United Brethren in Christ became a full-blown agency of the denomination under the direction of the General Conference. In 1878, women of the Methodist Episcopal Church South founded a Women's Missionary Society of this Southern denomination's Board of Missions, led by Mrs. Margaret Campbell Kelly and Mrs. Willie Harding McGavick. The very next year, 1879, the Methodist Protestant women voted to form the Women's Foreign Missionary Society of the Methodist Protestant Church, which was approved by that General Conference in 1880. Women of the Evangelical Association had founded their first local missionary society back in 1838 in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. But it wasn't until 1884 that they succeeded in gaining General Conference approval for the denomination-wide Women's Missionary Society. The detailed stories of these great women's achievements are told in a wide variety of primary and secondary sources. Their achievements, both individually and collectively, are inspiring and mind-blowing. When when we consider the obstacles that they faced and the impact of their work. In future videos, we'll take a more detailed look at how God called into action the faithful women and men who founded these missionary societies and those who were sent out to serve Christ in the mission field. I'm Professor Wendy. Thanks for watching, and as always, have fun learning.